And I think there are two reasons. So one is, if you look at the history, the last 20 years of the digital operations world, right? It started with shared services outsourcing, which was all about optimizing a function. Then we moved into GBSs and end-to-end processes, where instead of looking at accounts payable, we started to look at procure-to-pay, right? So we started to see convergence of silos. And now we're talking about the one office, wherein essentially it says that there's only one office that matters, and that's the office that caters to the customer. So what's beyond one office then, right? And beyond one office is when you get into what we call the hyper-connected enterprise, which is where there's not one organization which can be everything to anyone. And that is where ecosystems will have to come into play. And to develop those ecosystems, you'll have to use technologies like blockchain. So that is why organizations need to look at blockchain. And I think the other reason is blockchain is fundamentally different than whatever other emerging technologies that we've seen. I call it the blockchain six-pack, and there are basically six features. Number one, it's distributed, so it's not centralized. It's a distributed peer-to-peer sort of ledger. Number two, it's smart, it's intelligent, so you have inherent smart contracts built into blockchain. Number three, it's consensus-driven. It's based on an algorithm, so you don't have to rely on a particular person, right, to do it. Number four, it's secure. And by the way, security doesn't mean privacy, but it is secure. Nobody's been able to hack a blockchain. Number five, it's immutable, right? So you cannot, there's not even a concept of soft delete in blockchain. Now, that might be good or bad, but that's different, right? And number six, it's flexible. So we have now permissioned or permissionless blockchains, which is similar to private versus public clouds, which makes the usage sort of flexible. So I think those are really the two reasons, right? If you move to the hyper-connected world, then you need to look at blockchain. And then these are six inherently different features, the six-pack of blockchain, that makes it really interesting. The reality is that we've got a database of about 2,500 different blockchain engagements. And there are 5% of those engagements which are actually in production today. That makes it about 125 different engagements that we can count at HFS of blockchain solutions which are in production, where there's some live transaction happening, something coming in, something going out in the real world. And 125 is not a small number, right? It is quite a substantial amount of critical mass that we've started to generate. And that number was less than 10 just 12 months ago. So imagine from less than 10 to 125, more than a 10x growth in the number of in-production solutions is the reality. But there is a lot of hype as well. So I think the question is, how do you balance the hype versus the reality? And that is where we've come up with what we call the Blockchain Bullshit Buster. And the Blockchain Bullshit Buster is 10 simple business questions. And if you answer yes to most of them, then you're probably hitting blockchain gold. But if you have a lot of no's in there, then you know you're stinking something rotten. And you blockchain is maybe not the answer. So I think my advice is you need to evaluate each use case on its own merit and use something like our Blockchain Bullshit Buster or whatever you develop to actually figure out what is real versus what is just putting a cart in front of the horse, kind of a use case. Anything to do with supply chain is a huge adopter of blockchain. And that is largely because of provenance tracking. I think that is one of the hottest areas of blockchain use cases that we are seeing, is this improvement in supply chain through provenance tracking. And the reason behind why we are seeing so much adoption of that is the fact that there is no other solution out there. So blockchain is filling in the gap. Unlike a lot of banking financial services use cases where blockchain is trying to rip and replace an existing solution, in the supply chain provenance tracking kind of use cases, there is no solution. And filling in the blanks is much easier than sort of erasing something and writing on top of it, right? So I think provenance tracking is something that that is really, really exciting. In fact, we are doing a full-fledged report research on supply chain, blockchain in supply chain, and that's going to be releasing very, very soon.